days of 14th Sunday after Pentecost. This is the time of the church. This is the green season. It goes on and on and on, you know. But we're learning a lot. We're learning a lot as we go through this season. And this year we're reading basically through the Gospel of St. Luke. Today Jesus is telling us two stories about searching for lost, for the lost. One's a shepherd looking for a sheep, and one's a lady looking for a coin that she had lost. Be sure to wear your name tags, okay? And if they need to be changed in any way, just let me know. We'll take care of it. Yes. If you're interested, I'm learning things as we go along. There were people walking around last week. Is there an adult Sunday school class? Well, I don't know. who was in charge of that? Pastor Michael. Okay, so, yeah. So I just need to know who's interested in that. And also, we're putting together a new member, new disciple class soon. And it'd be nice to know who all is interested in that. And either I don't know where to look for things, or for a lot of folks, I don't have any contact information. So be sure to give me your email address or cell phone or whatever. Let's see. I'm going to put that right here. Everybody see this? Right here. I just know it's going to be filled with names when I come back after church. Yes. That was a joke. I usually have to teach congregations that laughter is okay. In fact, healthy. Other announcements this morning, anyone? Way back there, Dawn. For being able to get in the Facebook group.
No.
Just want to.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
figure out somebody that can help you get in. Yes. Yes. See, I'm the type of person that needs to be told how to get into something like that. And then her other announcement, did you hear everything? I usually am sitting and I go, I didn't hear a word. The Sunday school is collecting socks and underwear for the cold patrol all during October. There's a box out there. Okay, there we got it. Anything else that we need to share this morning? All right, well, here we go again. I'm going to ask you if you're a member or a regular worshiper to raise your hand and to look around and see who our guests are. So be sure that the people that didn't raise their hand, you see hands that aren't raised, folks that did raise your hand, don't let these people leave and be able to say sometime this week, well, I went and nobody talked to me. Got it?
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. Let's move along. Please stand for the peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace with one another.
Oh, that's the
Yes, strength of our ancestors, the host of this meal, the builder of the city that is to come.
Amen.
If we have died with Christ, we will also live with Christ. Let us confess our sin to the one who is faithful. God, our helper,
we confess the many ways we have failed to live as your disciples. We have not finished what we began. We have feasted with friends, but ignored strangers. We have been captivated by our possessions. Lift our burdens, gracious God. Refresh our hearts and forgive our sins. Raise us to the new life you have chosen for us, to Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
There is rejoicing in heaven when sinners repent. Put your trust in these promises. God will never leave you or forsake you. You who were lost have been found. For the sake of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Rejoice with the angels at this good news.
Amen.
Sustained and nurtured by our generous God, we gather as one to pray for the church, the world, and all of God's creation.
Lord, we pray especially for Frank Kenyon, Judy New, John Correll, Heidi Rivera, all those suffering loss from Hurricane Dorian, all those on our prayer list, and those we name aloud or in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
United as one body in Christ, we pray for First Lutheran in Nashville and Pastor Brian Cooper. We also pray for churches in the member countries of the Lutheran World Federation, especially for the churches in Colombia and Kenya. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our presiding bishop, Elizabeth Eaton, and our synod bishop, Kevin Sterling. We pray for our interim pastor, David Hood, the staff and ministry leaders of this congregation, and seminarian Elizabeth Hawkins. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all those serving in the military, guarding our freedom, especially Drew, Kevin, Logan, Mike, Sean, Laura Ann, Stephen, Jonathan, and Heidi. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God, overflowing with mercy and compassion, you lead back to yourself all those who go astray. Preserve your people in your loving care, that we may reject whatever is contrary to you, and may follow all things that sustain our life in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of the reading.
Our reading this morning is from Exodus chapter 32. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people, whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt, have acted perversely. They've been quick to turn aside from the way that I commanded them. They have cast for themselves an image of a calf and worshipped it and sacrificed to it and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.' The Lord said to Moses, 'I have seen this people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone so that my wrath may burn hot against them and I may consume them. And of you I will make a great nation.' But Moses implored the Lord his God and said, 'O Lord, why does your wrath burn hot against your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with great power and with a mighty hand? Why should the Egyptians say, it was with evil intent that he brought them out to kill them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth? Turn from your fierce wrath, change your mind, and do not bring disaster on your people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them that by your own self, saying to them, I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have promised I will give to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever. And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster that he planned to bring on his people. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for the reading of the gospel, the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Now all the tax collectors and sinners were coming near to listen to Jesus. And the Pharisees and the scribes were grumbling and saying, "This fellow welcomes sinners and eats with them." So Jesus told them this parable: "Which one of you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? When he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders and rejoices. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that was lost.' Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one of them, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? When she has found it, she calls together her friends and neighbors, saying, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found the coin that I had lost.' Just so I tell you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you,
Lord Christ.
And I invite children to come forward. And Madeline has the box for us today. Good morning. Now tell me, oh gosh, there's so many ways we can. going to skip this. People like the children's sermon better. Too bad. The story's told of a little boy who came running into his parents' bedroom one night because of a terrible thunderstorm. He was terrified of the lightning and the thunder. The little boy woke his parents up, went into their bedroom, and his dad said, "Son, go back to bed. You will be okay. Remember, God is with you." So the little boy goes back to his bedroom. Well, not too long, there's another big flash of lightning and a big clap of thunder. His bedroom window shakes and he hits the floor, runs straight back to the bedroom. And again, Dad says, "Remember, you're going to be okay. God is with you." Well, this happens several times. Finally, the last time that the father said, "Son, remember, God is with you," he said, "Yeah, but I want somebody with skin on." Today, Jesus tells us two stories about real life people who have real skin on them. A shepherd who has lost one of his 100 sheep, and a widow who has lost one of her 10 coins. Now, in both stories, the individuals search for that which is lost, and they don't give up. They don't give up. So, I was reading about this passage this week, and it's just amazing to me. There were actually cynics who were criticizing the stories. For example, the widow, she had lost one coin. Now, one coin for her, the cynic is talking here, is a lot of money. Why on earth would she, when she finds it, have a party? Why would she spend, she probably spent more than that coin was worth, having a party? Boy, you can't please anybody, huh? But the point here is there was great rejoicing. Great rejoicing. Then Shepherd was criticized by some for abandoning the 99 sheep. Well, okay, maybe. Because they were in such an inhospitable climate, terrain, geography. And the one sheep, the odds of that one sheep surviving alone was next to zero. But again, like the widow, the shepherd has a big party, invites all of his friends. The point is, there is great rejoicing. That's what Jesus is talking about. Don't dissect the story. Just listen about the intensity of finding the lost and the celebration when that which was lost is found. So what prompted Jesus to tell these two stories? He was being criticized. Boy, the world just keeps turning around and doesn't change much, does it? He was being criticized about the company he was keeping. "This fellow welcomes sinners and eats with them." Now, who was it that put the label sinner on the companions that Jesus was hanging around and eating with? Well, it was the religious establishment of the day. You see, the scribes and the Pharisees knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that they understood God better than anybody else. They knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that they knew how one was to enter into a relationship good children green, what color would you be? One little boy said, I'd be striped. That is wise. That is true. All of us are striped. We all have good and bad. Luther says we are at the same time, saint and sinner. Saint and sinner. Okay. It's a continuum. Saint, sinner. All right. So where are you in the middle? Kind of go back. Yeah. All of us are lost in some way. All of us need to be found. Jesus tells us today that to lose even one person would be tantamount to losing part of God. You see, all people bear the imprint of the Creator. You bear the imprint of the Creator. The recovery of the sinner is then not simply the recovery of something that has been lost. It's the recovery of God's image bearer. And what's more, God's imprint that is on each and every one of us is indelible. You can't wash it away. You can't go away from it. It's there. It's there. Our God searches for each and every one of us constantly. Even as God constantly searches for all humanity. Furthermore, Jesus is inviting all of us to come and eat with him and the tax collectors and the sinners. Why do we as people presume that we are in charge of Jesus' guest list? Some say that LGBTQ sisters and brothers cannot be on the guest list. Some say immigrants cannot be on the guest list. Some say the rich cannot be on the guest list. Some say, and you can just fill in the blank, because this list can go on and on. So what's a God to do? Remember the little boy who wanted someone with skin? That's exactly what God did. God took on skin. God took on flesh.
confess our faith together using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. And he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated, and we will receive our offering.
Our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Guard the good treasure entrusted to you with the help of the Holy Spirit living in us. Almighty God, bless you with grace, mercy, peace, now and forever.
Amen.
Live in love as Christ loved us.
Thanks be to God.